Everybody had a nice coffee? Good. So you are ready probably for one interesting lecture. And I'm sure in case of some of you, this is going to be a life-changing experience. This will change your life. The topic is effortless weight loss and diabetes prevention. And I have realized why people attend this lecture is because of the word effortless. Many obese people feel that their obesity should be reduced by somebody else. They don't want to do anything for themselves. So whatever I'm going to tell you is not exactly effortless, but it is less effort. So people might have tried different methods to lose weight, but this is a way which is a very simple method and you can follow it throughout your life. Next.
Sorry.
You have heard about Dr. Srikant Jiskar. Just now person told about him that I got inspired because of the work of Dr. Srikant Jiskar. People from Maharashtra know about him a lot. But let me tell you something about him. Dr. Jiskar, his name has appeared in Limca Book of World Records for possessing the highest postgraduate degrees of universities. He was MBBS, he was MD in community medicine. He became IPS, he became IAS. In first attempt, he also contested election and became MLA of Maharashtra Assembly. At some point of time, he had, as a minister, 11 portfolios. So he's a very efficient person, intelligent person. He was a member of parliament also. And he represented India on different national, international fora. But why I'm quoting his name? Because the diet plan or lifestyle modification that I'm going to tell you was initially propagated by Dr. Jiskar in this country. And whatever research he did at that time, since 1997 to 2004, till his death in an accident, he continued to propagate this idea and this diet plan. So whatever I am doing now is only carrying forward his work, what he has done. So this campaign, which is the India Free of Obesity and Diabetes campaign, and this lecture is dedicated to the memory of late Dr. Jiskar. I know I am speaking to medical students, so there is always a danger that you will misquote me later, that it was told by Dr. Dixit. So I am responsible for what I say. I am not responsible for what you understand. Because as a teacher, for last 27 years, I know teaching is an illusion. We, as teachers, we think many times that we have taught so many things to the student, but learning is the reality. So, as a teacher, as a speaker, I'm going to give 100%. I'm doing my job 100%. You have to take the responsibility of understanding. And if you take that responsibility 100%, then only this transaction of give and take would happen. So my urge is listen very carefully to what I am saying. Some confessions, very important. I am not a practicing doctor. I don't have a clinic or a hospital. I am not a dietitian or nutritionist. Nowadays, these people are very famous for reducing your weight. And some people charge, they say, 1 lakh rupees per consultation. I am not a fitness expert. I don't have a gymnasium. Even I am not a diabetologist also. So many students sitting at the far end, they must be thinking that they should slip away from this hall. Because I am going to speak about weight loss and diabetes prevention, but I am not expert in any of these fields. So, because we are used to listen to experts, and if somebody tells you a very simple method, we want rocket science. We don't want simple things. So, but one more thing, because I am talking to medical students and doctors, I don't answer for all your questions. Maybe sometimes you have to find out answer for yourself. Okay, but before you are really disappointed, let me tell you who I am. I am a sincere student. Whatever degrees you saw on my slide, I got it by studying properly. Okay. I am a dedicated teacher and honest researcher, very important. That if research is not honest, it will harm the society. So the research about wine can prevent heart attacks. How many have heard about this? A lot of research papers on that. And then it was found out that the person was sponsored by wine industry to publish such research. So the research should be honest. So I am honest researcher. Whatever I will tell you is the truth that I really found. And I am a person who is working with a purpose in the last 27 years to create social awareness in medical students and health awareness in the society. And very importantly, I do not have any vested interest in this campaign. I don't want to earn a single pie from this campaign. That's the reason what I'm telling you should be able to believe what I'm saying. Now, why this lecture? As it was already said, that because obesity and diabetes are the problems on increase. They're like epidemics that are happening. And obesity itself is a disease, but it's a risk factor for so many other diseases, like hypertension. If you put on 1 kg weight, your systolic blood pressure will go up by 2 mm. So the other side of it is, if you reduce 10 kg, your systolic would go down by 20 mm of mercury. So the people who are obese, if they lose weight, their blood pressure tablet medicine will also be reduced. Diabetes, then brain hemorrhage and all that, those things happen because of obesity. Now, very important that obesity is not a disease, it is not incurable. So, I am going to suggest a lifestyle modification or diet plan which doesn't require, you don't have to spend a single pie. That is one thing, it is free of cost. Second thing, you don't have to go to a doctor or expert. Third, you don't have to buy any machine. You don't have to buy any machine or equipment for that. And very important fact is that you can follow this lifestyle throughout your life without any problem. Now, why all diet plans which cause weight loss fail? The reason is people take Herbalife, people take Amway products, people do gymming and all that. But what happens? They can do it for 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months. They will lose 5 kg, 6 kg. And they stop doing it, again it will increase. So this diet plan, the peculiarity is you can follow it for lifetime without any problem. And now there is a scheme also, buy one, get one free. So we used to schemes, isn't it? Unless and until you get one shirt free on one, you don't buy. So we are also having a scheme that if you follow this diet plan, not only you lose weight, but you will also prevent your diabetes. So with the same plan, both things are going to happen. This diet plan is not useful for three types of people. One, whose age is less than 18, none of you is like that. Second, those who already have diabetes. Maybe this lecture would be useful for you so that you can help your relatives, friends who are having this problem. But the people with diabetes can also follow this diet plan, provided they will do two tests, one we call HbA1c. I think all of you know, that is glycosylated hemoglobin. And second test is fasting insulin. Now, you are all used to do fasting sugar, but I am asking for fasting insulin. It's a different test. So those who are having diabetes should do these two tests, HbA1c fasting insulin. Share the reports with me on my WhatsApp. And if I tell you to follow the diet plan, you can follow the diet plan and you will get benefit. So less than 18 years, out of question. Diabetics with conditions, they can follow. And there is a third type also. If you ask me in the question answer session, what is the third type, I will give the answer, not now. I think this picture is very common. If you look around you, you can see people like this. A lot of UN cry about equality, gender equality, male, females. So in this area of obesity, males and females have reached equality. This picture I'm showing specifically for us because we travel a lot in train, bus and all. These companies have decided now to take your ticket by per kilogram body weight. Not like, because they cannot afford 40 kg same rate and 100 kg same rate. So be careful. You have to travel a lot. You are students. You'll have to spend a lot of money later if you don't take care now. The earlier pictures were of people more than 40 years of age. We say wrong side of 40. Already half of their life has gone. What about the children? Your brothers, sisters who are 9th standard, 10th standard. And this was a study conducted in a city, Pune, which is a metro city in Maharashtra. And what they found, in 9th standard, 30% of the children are obese. So we are heading towards USA. The USA is a country which is the most, it is the richest but the sickest country of the world. Why? Because 1/3 of the population is obese. So we are also heading towards that. So unless and until we take care, we will land into the same problem. Married people would appreciate this more. Okay. So most of you are unmarried, but maybe later. So this situation should not come, that the husband wants to embrace his wife, but he has to take an extension for that because it's difficult to reach. Okay. Now, I think all our medical students, I don't have to tell this to you, but a simple method that we, a simple formula that we tell in this campaign is, take your height in centimeters and subtract 100 from that. That is your maximum allowable weight. So all of you know your height in centimeters. Average Indian male is 5 feet 6 inches. So 165 centimeters minus 100. So your weight should be maximum 65 kg. Average Indian woman is 5 feet. So 150 centimeters. So weight should be 50 kg. That is maximum. It should be less. So now you know how much overweight you are. Isn't it? A simple exercise. You know how much overweight you are. See, accepting this fact that you are overweight is the first step to solve the problem. So if you don't accept that you are overweight, you are never going to solve the problem. So now you know that you are maybe 10 kg overweight or 15 kg overweight or 30 kg overweight, whatever it is. Don't worry. With my formula, the diet plan that I'm going to suggest, you are going to lose. Next 1 year, you will be seen a different person if you follow this plan. So why we should worry about obesity? Because as I said, it's a disease, but it's a risk factor for so many conditions. It's a long list. And I think I don't have to tell much about this. Obesity, we say, is of two types. One is apple-shaped, other is pear-shaped. Also said, android obesity, gynecoid obesity. A central obesity, peripheral obesity. Now, suppose you are forced to take one obesity. And we used to ask this question about marasmus and kwashiorkor to our students. Now, suppose you are forced to take one, what you should take? Then don't take kwashiorkor, take marasmus. Because marasmus, baby is adapted baby. You will survive for a longer time. Here, if you are forced to take one, it is better to take the pear-shaped, not the apple-shaped. Because it is the central obesity which is has more risk of all those conditions that I mentioned earlier, of hypertension, diabetes, and stroke and all that. So what you will do now after going to your hostels? Look into the mirror, but not like this, sideways. So that you will see your apple or pear, whatever you are having. But don't worry, whatever you are having, in 1 year you will be flat. If you follow this diet plan, you will be flat. Don't worry. You can tease each other as of now. Why we put on weight? As our age increases, our weight increases. And in case of children, we say, unless and until the weight increase, we say the development is not proper. In case of males, it is the age group of 25 to 29 when they will put on maximum weight. In case of females, it is 45 to 49, which is the menopausal age group. Because of hormonal disturbances, they will put on weight. Females are more prone to develop, to have more weight as compared to males. Generally, we blame our obesity on genetic factors. We say that my father is like that, my mother is like that, so I have got it as a heredity, property from my parents. But remember, out of 100 obese persons, only one person has got it from his parents. 99 have earned it themselves. So don't blame your genetic factors for that. Socioeconomic status, more money, more food, more obesity. Lack of exercise. People don't play any game. Whatever games you have played, it was only up to 10th standard or 9th standard. So a national champion of table tennis up to 10th standard suddenly stops playing in 11th, 12th, because there are classes and NEET and whatnot. So no exercise. People are having motorcycles, two-wheelers, cars and all that. So you don't travel, you don't have any physical exercise. So that is one of the reasons. Education. Education should make you more aware about the problem. It should make you health aware, health conscious. But what we are seeing now, if you go to your canteens, what you find is people eating burger or pizza in one hand and Pepsi in other hand. That's how the US people are falling, and you are following US. And the reason, you will also land up into the same problem of US. So education is giving a counterproductive result for us. Some hormones like insulin cause weight gain. I'm going to speak about insulin in some detail later because it is the hero of our story. Alcohol. Alcohol per se will not cause weight gain, but people eat too many things with alcohol. They will continue drinking for 3 hours, 4 hours like that. So they will put on weight. Smoking, it is said that smokers have less weight as compared to non-smokers. So some of the boys must be interested now. That Dr. Dixit has advised now to lose weight, you can smoke. But a good saying about smoking, they say that smokers never get old. They die before that. So if anybody has got this idea of smoking, this is not useful for us. Right? Black or Negroes are more prone for obesity. Oral contraceptive pills, insulin when you give in a patient of diabetes as injection, the side effect is weight gain. And the anabolic steroids that people take, wrestlers, boxers, they are caught under doping, that also cause weight gain. So these are different factors that cause weight gain. Now look at the things that are, how things have changed. Look at the computer of 80 and your smartphone of 2017 does everything of a computer. So people are getting obese and gadgets are becoming small. This fellow wants to play, and what he's saying, hey, I want to exercise, where are my tennis shoes? And look at him, he's already wearing tennis shoes, but he cannot see because there is a barrier of his belly in between. So you can see such people here also. And there is a fad also of diet soda, zero calories, isn't it? The people who are very fond of health and all that. So this fellow is asking for diet soda now. Now if you look at him, you can assume that he has consumed everything available in the hotel. And at the end now he wants diet soda. So coming to the reality, I told you many reasons for obesity and why you put on weight. But the real reason is energy in is more than energy out. So there is a positive energy balance and you put on weight because of that. So it is rightly said that don't blame your parents. Obesity doesn't run in family, but the problem is nobody runs in the family. You start running, you lose energy and you lose your weight. Okay, now sharing some success stories with you. And these success stories are of doctors who are practicing in Maharashtra, different places. Maybe soon we will get success stories from this college also. And they allowed me to show their pictures as well as what they achieved with their mobile numbers. The reason of giving mobile number is you can call these people and ask how they have done it. So what she is saying, 7 kg weight loss, HbA1c reduced from 9.9 to 6.5 without any medicine. Now remember, HbA1c is a test which gives us idea about last 3 months average blood sugar. So it is more robust as compared to your fasting post meal blood sugar of 1 day. Normal it is up to 5.7, 5.8 to 6.3 is pre-diabetes, 6.4 onwards is diabetes. That's how we define it. So this gynecologist, she was having 9.9, means she was already diabetic, but she reduced it to 6.5 without medicine with this diet plan. Also she lost weight. This is Dr. Walwekar from Nashik, who is an oncosurgeon. And he followed the diet plan for 1 year. He lost 16.5 kg. And HbA1c reduced from 6.9 to 5.3, from diabetic state to non-diabetic state. Without medicine, only diet plan. Okay. He allowed me to share his pictures also, before after. The Dr. Nandan Vankar is Associate Professor of Anesthesia, Government Medical College, Nanded. HbA1c reduced from 6.6 to 5.9. So, diabetic to pre-diabetic. Dr. Shilpa Maniyar, HbA1c 5.5 to 4.5, weight 61 to 55 by following this diet plan without medicine. Now, you must be wondering how this happened. How this can happen? Somebody loses 16.5. Oncosurgeon is losing. See, not a common man. So you must be expecting something, a complicated formula for this. Okay, I started at what time? 11:45? No. I know. Okay. So, I am going to take 45 minutes, as I said. Okay, so I won't spend much time on these experiments. And why I entered into this weight loss activity, I was a teacher in community medicine, I was doing my job. But in 2012, I realized that I have put on weight. I was 8 kg more than what was expected. And I tried different methods, different experiments. So, this is the list of different experiments. Anybody knows General Motors diet? Anybody who knows General Motors diet? None of you know. Very good. Because these are all failed experiments. Don't write down. Some people are very sincere. They will write down. So these are all failed experiments. So fasting has failed. Eating only fruits in the night has failed. Then fruits one day, then juices other day, and fasting third day, like cycle repeat again and again. That also failed. General Motors diet also failed. Ayurvedic homeopathic medicines, they also failed. And lastly, that book about the heroine, Kareena Kapoor. Have you heard about that book? Lose Your Weight, Don't Lose Your Mind. That the famous dietitian Rujuta Divekar has written that book. And in that book, the advice is every 2 to 3 hours you should eat something. I tried that also. And I put on 3 kg weight in 2 months. Naturally, the obese people have put on weight because they are eating again and again. And here in this book, officially it is advised that you eat something every 2 to 3 hours. So, all these experiments I have done very honestly. So, I can tell you what worked and what didn't work. So, the result of all those experiments that I did was either I put on weight or I lost some weight. But as soon as I stopped that activity, that particular diet plan, again it went back to the normal level. So I was on the square one all the time. And this must be the, how many of you are trying to lose weight? Okay, quite a good number. Okay, so this lecture is going to help most of you. I'll take fees next time. So, that was my situation after trying so many experiments. I thought this is the only way probably to burn my fat. Okay, so all of us laughed at this cartoon. But when you go for liposuction, when you go for bariatric surgery, stapling of the stomach and bypass, not allowing the food to go into the small intestine, directly going to the large intestine and passing. These are the cruel methods that people are following for losing weight. So, none of us want to do that, isn't it? We want to lose weight by a natural way where we can enjoy your food. You can enjoy your food and lose weight. And when I was in that frustrating situation, I came across one YouTube lecture by late Dr. Jiskar. And he explained a very simple method to lose weight and prevent diabetes, and the method which I am going to tell you now. And in his lecture, he said very simple advice. What was the advice? He said, eat twice in the day. In between, don't eat anything. Only drink water. That was the advice. So the way you are astonished, I was also like that, amazed. How it can happen? Because he is not saying that reduce your food. He is not saying don't eat non-veg. He is not saying don't eat ghee, butter, all that. What he is telling you is only eat twice. Don't open your mouth for eating. Only talk or drink water. That's what he's saying. So I was really surprised. I said, how it can happen? Because we are into calories in, calories out and all that. So I said, but because I knew about Dr. Jiskar as a very talented person, I said, let me try it for 3 months because I had tried so many methods. So I tried this method. And in 3 months, I lost 8 kg. And I lost 2 inches from my belly. So my pant size, 34 inches, became 32 inches. So I was really happy and surprised that this plan really works. This plan really works. But then I had a doubt in my mind because my mother was having diabetes. Many uncles are having diabetes. I thought, I am losing weight because of diabetes and I am giving credit to Dr. Jiskar. So I did all the investigations and found that I am absolutely all right. There's no problem. And when I realized this as a teacher, that yes, this simple diet plan, which is appropriate for a country like India, where we cannot spend a lot of money on either weight loss or diabetes prevention, is good for the society. And then I started experimenting with students, colleagues, friends, relatives, and all that. And I found that everybody loses weight. And the beauty of this diet plan is you will lose your weight from your belly first. Your cheeks will never retract. If you do excess gymming, people would start asking you, what is the problem? Is there any stress in the family? But here, you lose from your belly. Everybody wants to lose from the belly. So this is diet plan. This is the only diet plan. Okay. Now coming to very important slide, 2-3 slides, very important in this lecture. That what is this theory all about? What is this theory? The theory says that it is the insulin level in your blood that makes you obese and it causes diabetes. Now, insulin secretion happens by 2 ways in our body. One is called baseline secretion, which happens 24 hours, and you secrete around 18 to 32 units of insulin in 24 hours. This secretion you cannot stop. This is a baseline secretion required for survival. Now, it is expected that the other way of secreting insulin is by eating. When you eat, insulin is secreted. It is expected that 18 to 32 units is your baseline. You should secrete 18 to 32 units by eating. Total would be 100%. So baseline secretion you cannot stop. By eating, you should secrete 18 to 32 units. Now whenever you take food, insulin is secreted. Now the peculiarity of this insulin secretion, everybody should understand, is that everybody has got a measure of insulin. Somebody may have 5 units, somebody has 6, 8, 10 units like that. So if you eat, say, half chapati or half bowl of rice, or you eat fruit salad, ice cream, a complete meal you take, then also more or less the same amount of insulin is secreted. It is not dependent on the quantity of food that you consume. But every time you eat, a peculiar amount of insulin in your body would be secreted. And it can be different for different people, 5 units, 10 units, 20 units, depending on the person. So it is not that the quantity, but every time you eat, same amount of insulin would be secreted. Is it clear to you? Good. Another peculiarity of insulin secretion is, once it is secreted, that measure gets emptied, to refill it takes 55 minutes. Means, what is the meaning of it? If you eat up to 55 minutes, you will secrete insulin only once. If you extend this limit of 55, your insulin would be secreted again. This is important because in our diet plan we say finish your meal within 55 minutes because we don't want to secrete insulin again. So what I said, baseline secretion and secretion by eating. I said 18 to 32 units baseline, you cannot stop. Every time you eat, peculiar amount of insulin in your body would be secreted. And it is not dependent on quantity of food. And third thing I said, that it is secreted once in 55 minutes. If you extend eating more than that, you will secrete it again. Is it clear to you? Insulin. Okay. Now, what is the action of insulin? Everybody is, I think, third year, second year. In physiology, we learned about this. After digestion, you have got 3 products. Glucose, amino acid, fatty acids. Right? And they are absorbed in your blood. Now, your cells have got 2 fuels to burn to get energy. One is glucose, which will give 1 gram. If you burn, it will give you 4 calories. And if you burn fatty acids, 1 gram, you will get 9 calories, right? So if you are a cell, what do you like to burn? Glucose or fatty acid? Because 1 gram glucose will give 4 calories. 1 gram fatty acid will give you 9 calories. So what do you like to burn? Fat. Common sense, because in same work you can get 9 calories. So all cells of your body are happy to burn fats, except brain cells. Brain cells can only use glucose. It is the exception. But all other cells like to burn fatty acids. So what happens now in your, after digestion in your blood, there is glucose, there is fatty acid, there are amino acids. Now the glucose will go to the cell, but it cannot enter directly into the cell because there is something called insulin receptor, right? So the insulin receptor will get attached to the insulin receptor so that the cell wall allows the glucose to enter. And that is the function of insulin, to push glucose into the cell. That is the first function. The exception to this rule is again brain cells. They can take glucose directly from the blood. Is it clear? So all other cells of your body, muscle cells and all, they require insulin so that glucose has to enter. So the first function of insulin is to make the glucose go into the cell. That is one. Second, if there is excess glucose, it is converted to glycogen, 100 gram in liver. So in case of emergency, you can get 400 calories. If you have more glucose, what happens? Under the influence of insulin, this glucose is converted to fatty acids and stored as fat. And that explains one query of many people, that I am not eating butter, I am not eating ghee, I am throwing the yellow also from the egg, still how I am putting on weight? Is because what chapati and rice you are eating, your insulin is converting it into fatty acids and storing as fat. So this is the way it converts amino acid into useful proteins, it converts fatty acid into fats and stores. So insulin is a conserving hormone, it will conserve energy in your body. And there is a concept called day cycle and night cycle in physiology. That when your insulin levels are high, your body uses glucose as fuel. When your insulin levels go down, body uses fatty acid for fuel. And when this happens nicely, you don't put on weight. Is it clear what I am saying? What is the function of insulin? I said glucose goes to cell, glucose is stored as glycogen, glucose converted to fatty acids and stored as fats. Okay, and when glucose level is high, body uses glucose. When insulin level is low, body will use fatty acids. And if you go for hyperinsulinemia, raised levels of insulin in your body, you will get hundreds of articles which say about risk associated with that. Hypertension, diabetes, dyslipidemia and all that. And one more important thing that happens because of raised levels of insulin is our cells are not used to high levels of insulin. Our cells are made for low levels of insulin. So they develop resistance, which what we call as insulin resistance. So what happens if there is insulin resistance? If your measure of insulin secretion was 10 units and you develop insulin resistance, what happens? Your insulin secretion would increase, but the cells would create resistance to that. So that insulin, you will increase the insulin secretion, but that will not be effective. So the glucose cannot go into the cells. And slowly a stage comes when the insulin levels are high, glucose is in the blood, but the glucose cannot enter the cells and it is passed through your urine and you lose weight. And you go to the doctor and you are diagnosed to have diabetes. So it is not that you are not producing insulin, you land into diabetes, but it is you are producing more insulin which is ineffective. It is ineffective that you land into diabetes. I am speaking about type 2 diabetes, not about type 1. This campaign is only about type 2 diabetes. So is it clear about insulin function and insulin secretion? Okay. This I have already told you. Now if the insulin levels go down, exactly opposite things start. First your body will use the glucose in the blood. Then it will use glucose from the glycogen. And when you don't have glycogen also now, what will happen? Your body will start your fats. So you are all talented people. If you want to lose weight, if you want to lose fats, what you have to do now is reduce your insulin levels. Reduce your, and how to do that? Is eating less important? Eating less times is important. Eating frequency to be reduced is very important. Okay, this is my example. How many times I was secreting insulin before I started with that then? It was 8 to 10 times I was secreting insulin. So if my measure was say 8 units, I was secreting 64 units and I required maximum 32 units. So that excess insulin was making me obese and it might have caused me diabetes also. Okay, now I am coming to the diet plan. I am coming to the solution, what we can do. So first thing is very important and maybe very difficult for some of you. Identify two times when you are really hungry in the day. I am sure many of you have not experienced real hunger. Because you eat too many times, you don't get that feeling of real hunger. Anyway, if you don't know, then there are two patterns that exist in the world. One is 9 a.m., 6 p.m. Other pattern is 1 p.m., 9 p.m. So you can choose either of the two patterns as per your convenience. So first thing is, fix two times of your meals. And you have to eat at that time every day now, once you fix the time. 15-20 minutes variation is okay. Suppose you fix the time as 1, then 12:45 to 1:15, you can start your meal. There is no restriction of any food item. You can eat whatever you want to eat. Suppose tomorrow you want to start this diet plan, count what you have consumed today. You can eat the same quantity and variety tomorrow also. The only thing you have to do is divide into two parts. First meal and second meal. And you can consume all that. So no restriction on food item. You can eat sweets also if you are non-diabetic. No problem. Finish your meal in 55 minutes. Very important. Why? Because if you eat for more time, insulin will be secreted again. And we don't want that. I'm not saying that you should eat for 55 minutes. You can finish in 10 minutes also. I am saying maximum time allowed is 55 minutes because you can accommodate all food items you want. Fruits, milk, whatever you want to eat, you can have that. But in 55 minutes. In general, I am telling you, you are non-diabetic, but still avoid sweets and sugars in your diet because they are not good for health. Modern scientists are nowadays telling that diabetes is caused by insulin and sugar. So avoid sweets as little you can eat, no problem. But if you reduce sweets in your diet, your weight loss would be very fast. And increase proteins in your diet. Indian diets are full of carbohydrates. So vegetarian, if you are vegetarian, you can increase sprouts, you can eat soya bean, you can eat cheese, paneer, like that. If you are non-vegetarian, no problem. Then eggs, chicken, meat, fish, you can eat. So that you should increase proteins in the diet, reduce carbohydrates. That will help you in weight loss. So what is the diet plan I said? Fix two times of your hunger. Eat at that time. 15-20 minute variation is okay. No restriction on food item. No restriction on quantity also. You can eat the same quantity that you are eating today. Avoid sweets and increase proteins in your diet. Finish your meal in 55 minutes and don't eat anything in between. So to avoid your frustration, this slide I am showing. That what you can take in between? Water, as much as you want. Buttermilk you can take, not from any company, but homemade. Because all buttermilks that are sold in the market contain a lot of carbohydrates. They may have added sugars also. So don't take that. You can take green tea, black tea if you want, if you like it. You can take lemon water. You can take coconut water. Or you can eat one tomato. Only one tomato. Don't eat half kg tomatoes. So this is what is allowed in between. But what is highlighted here is, for best results, because this is stopgap arrangement, because you are eating 7-8 times now, tomorrow you will again directly shift to twice a day eating, so you will have some starting trouble. So to help you in that, these are the items that are allowed. Why these items are allowed? Because these items do not cause insulin secretion. And how do we know this? To test for insulin secretion, what you will do? Suppose you want to test for aloe vera juice. Take the juice and go to the lab. Give your blood. Suppose it is 8 a.m. in the morning. You give first blood for the fasting insulin. Then consume the aloe vera juice. Then after 10 minutes, give another sample. 8:10, second sample. And 9 a.m., third sample. And you have to see your insulin levels. If the insulin level in three samples is going down, insulin not secreted, you can take that food. If it is like this, it means insulin is secreted. So don't take that food item. I have tried 18 different food items on myself given blood 54 times, spent 30,000 rupees, and understood that these are the items that don't cause insulin secretion. So don't ask about any other item. If you want to, you can test it on yourself and find out whether it causes insulin secretion or not. Is it clear to you? What is the diet plan? Eat twice, fix the time, 55 minutes, finish the meals. Don't take anything in between. These are the items that you can take in between. Is there any support in religion, culture about this? Ayurveda says, dvau kala bhunjati, and eat twice. Vedas say, if you eat twice, the person who eats twice, get the punya of fasting. Everybody is doing a lot of punya. This is the easiest way of gathering punya. Eat twice. Jainism, there is a concept of basna. If there is somebody who belongs to Jainism, there is a concept of basna, means be asan, means two times you have to sit and eat. And Jainism says, you finish your meal in 48 minutes. We are giving grace period of 7 minutes. So Jainism says the same thing, Veda says same thing, Ayurveda says, but you are all modern students, 21st century. I have to give you something modern also. So this is Dr. Mattson, what he has to say. He is a good researcher in intermittent energy restriction. And this is the article on meal frequency and timing in health and disease, and what he has to say. I will read only this part. The most common eating pattern in modern society is 3 meals plus snacks every day is abnormal from evolutionary perspective. But this is Dr. Mattson is saying. And this problem is created by Britishers all over the world. So they started tea, they distributed it free of cost in India. So Indians, we take anything if it is free of cost. But today we purchase it, the tea, 500 rupees a kg. So because there was no tea, there was no biscuits, no bread, no khari, no samosa, nothing was there. People used to eat only twice. There was no concept of snacks in this country. In Sanskrit, there is no parallel word for breakfast. Sanskrit is our mother original language. It has no word for breakfast. So Indians were eating only twice. That was our culture. So you may listen to Veda, Ayurveda, Jainism, Dr. Dixit, Dr. Mattson, whatever. But everybody is saying eat twice. Okay, exercise. There are so many exercises. But remember, nobody loses weight only because of exercise. Why? If you eat, if you run, say, for 6 kilometers, you will spend, suppose average weight, you will spend around 400 calories. And if you eat 2 samosas, you will get 450 calories. And samosas you finish in 5 minutes. And you have to run for 1 hour. So there is a inverse proportion. So no, with only exercise, you won't lose weight. But the exercise that we suggest is, you have to walk 4.5 kilometers in 45 minutes. So it has to be brisk walk. And you can do it for 5 to 6 days every week. Not necessarily do every day. But 5 to 6 days a week is okay. Other exercise, gym, weight training, yoga, everything, as per your choice and as per your convenience. Some scientific evidence, some research paper that I have published on that. If you go to Google and put my name, you can get these research papers. This was an International Journal of Clinical Trials. And what it has to say? 428 people followed the diet plan for 6 months. Average weight loss in 6 months is 6.8 kg. Without spending money, without going to doctor. Range is 3 to 20 kg in 6 months. And 3.5 centimeters, means 1.5 inches belly loss. The range 1 centimeter to 10 centimeters. And it also prevents or postpones diabetes. Because as I said, fasting insulin, the range, pathologists say 2 to 25 is normal range. But when you are fasting, do you require insulin? Because insulin is required when you eat something. So it should be as low as possible. Your fasting insulin should be near zero. I am practicing this for 4 years. My fasting insulin is around 4.5. So one Ayurvedic doctor came to me, her fasting insulin was 25. And she followed the diet plan for 1 year. It came down to 5. She lost 6 kg weight as a bonus. What does that mean? If your fasting insulin decreases from 25 to 5, it means your body was needing 25 units of insulin to work. Now it can work only with 5 units. It means your insulin sensitivity has increased, insulin resistance is getting reduced, which means your diabetes is getting postponed. So that is the way how it postpones diabetes. Okay, some case studies, I don't have much time, but his HbA1c was 15.8, average blood sugar 340. Without medicine, it has become 6.5. Mrs. Rane, 7.2 to 5.2, without medicines. So you can revert diabetes. Okay. You may be wondering that we are students, we have to go here and there, we have to attend classes and all that, whether I will lose stamina or something like that. So I am showing some of my pictures to you. First time in my life, in 2013, Goa, I went to Goa. I finished in 2 hours 56 minutes. This is next year, 2 hours 54 minutes. This is next year, 2 hours 46 minutes. You have to run 21 kilometers. I don't know how many of you can walk 21 kilometers. This is Satara Hill Marathon, 2 hours 47 minutes. This is Aurangabad Marathon, 2 hours 35 minutes. This is Mumbai Standard Chartered, 2 hours 47 minutes. What I'm trying to prove is I can run 21 kilometers because I eat only twice. It has not affected my stamina. And this is another thing. I donate blood every year. I started in 1983 when I was in second year. I donated more than 50 times. So if you have to donate blood, your HbA should be more than 12.5 at least. So my HbA is around 15 all the times. So 14, 15, 16, 17, I donate blood every year at least. So if you can donate blood, if you can run 21 kilometers, is this diet plan going to cause loss of stamina in your case? Are you worried about it? Nothing is going to happen. No mineral deficiency, no vitamin deficiency. Only you will lose weight. Okay. Now, few words about the campaign. We have started this campaign, India Free of Obesity and Diabetes. And we are using this WhatsApp and Facebook for this campaign. There are 97 WhatsApp groups. We created yesterday, I had a lecture in Madras Management Association at Pondicherry. And we created a Pondicherry group also for you. It is a 98th group. So 17,000 or more followers. 35 countries, people are in this campaign. As it was told, so many leaders and all that. There is a YouTube video available, Effortless Weight Loss. You can go through that. We are presently involved in reversal of diabetes and pre-diabetes. And we want to know which food items cause insulin secretion. Okay. You can take the photograph of this particular slide. How to join our campaign? And if you want to join your campaign yourself, you want to lose weight, or you want to include your relatives in this campaign, this is the number. This is one number of mine. You can send a WhatsApp message on this. Okay? I could have given Amol's number also, actually. Okay. And these are few more numbers. You can take Advocate Prabhakaran and all those people. You can send message to any of them. They will add you to this WhatsApp group. What is the advantage of WhatsApp group? We share success story every morning of people who have lost weight or reverted diabetes or maybe reduced the doses and all that. This is a platform where you can ask your questions. I will answer your question within 24 hours. You can share your reports of HbA1c and fasting insulin. I will get it instantly on WhatsApp. So that is the purpose of joining WhatsApp group. On this WhatsApp group, we don't allow good morning, good night, RIP, anniversary, flag hosting and all that. If you do it, one warning and you are removed. Okay. So these groups won't cause any problem to you. It will be only useful communication, what is required in this diet plan. So with this,